Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to verify the following trig identity. There's two ways to verify it. We could start with one side and then simplify it or just work through it until we finally make it look like the other side using identities. Or what we could do is do this. You just put a line underneath. And then we could work on one side, but if we get stuck, we can then go to the other side and work on that side till we get exactly the same thing on both sides. So that's how I'm going to work this particular problem. So the sine of x plus y over the sine of x cosine of y. Let's start with that. Usually you start with the harder side. So in this case, because it has the sine of x plus y, I'm going to use the identity for the sine of a sum. So that becomes sine x cosine y plus cosine x sine of y. And that's all over sine x cosine y. Right, now we have a sum in the numerator and a monomial here on the denominator, so I can split the denominator. Each of these terms in the numerator goes over the denominator. So that's sine x cosine y over sine x cosine y plus cosine x sine y over sine x cosine y. Okay, so let's look at this first term. Let's see, the sine x over sine x cancel, cosine y over cosine y cancel, so that's just going to be a 1. And over here, nothing cancels, but you might notice you've got a cosine of x over sine x, and you have a sine y over a cosine y. So putting the first two together, I'm going to get cotangent x, and the second two together, I'm going to get a tangent of y, and I'm going to be done with my problem here. So I have 1 plus. These first terms, factors actually, you see, cosine x over sine x really is the cotangent of x, and sine y over cosine y is the tangent of y, and now you have the same thing on both sides. So this problem would have been easy enough to do by just writing sine of x plus y over sine of x cosine y and saying that that equals to this, equals to this, equals to this, which is what we wanted to prove, which is the more formal way of doing a proof. You could have also taken an extra step right here and written this as cosine x over sine x times sine y over cosine y. So if you wanted to show every single step, you could do that. Most people can go directly from here, it's so close. So here's the more formal way you might see it written. It says verify sine of x plus y over sine x cos y equals 1 plus cotangent x tangent y. And here the proof is you take what side you're going to really be working on, which in this case will be the left side, and then you show the steps. So you said equals, and first I am rewriting the sine of x plus y is what you see in the numerator. And then equals, the next step would be to show how you're putting each term in the numerator over the denominator. And the third step shown canceling, and the cosine of x over sine x is cotangent x, sine of y over cosine y is tangent y, and I write QED, which means that which is to be proved. You don't have to write that, but just in case you see that, I just want to let you know what that stands for. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.